Strana mentí. It is true that everything is Atma, but Atma is free from everything. That is how to be recognized. So that is something I am having difficulty comprehending.
You see, clay is all the parts.
Right.
But clay is different from the parts.
Correct.
Because the parts are a modification of clay. So, part cannot be without the clay. Okay. But clay is very much without the parts.
Can be, okay.
Clay is.
Right.
You know, parts are not different from clay, but clay is different from parts. Another example is of an actor taking the role of a beggar. The beggar is not separate from actor. The actor is independent of the beggar.
Actor can take any role.
Right.
Okay.
In fact, there is no roleness in actor as such from the standpoint of actor.
Right.
There is no beggarness at all. Because actor is satyam, beggar is mithya. Clay is satyam, part is mithya.
Okay.
So mithya cannot without satyam. But satyam is independent of mithya. So atma and anatma. Anatma is superimposing on atma, or anatma is atma appearing as anatma.
Right.
So anatma is mithya, atma is satyam. That's the relationship between atma and anatma.
But even further, I mean, you know, Pujya Swamiji says, even satyam jnanam anantam are not the characteristics of the Atma. They are words revealing the nature of Atma by implication. They reveal the vastu and resolve.
You see, the thing is, that when it is character, what we should say is, that satyam jnanam Atma is not the literal meaning of lakshyartha of these words. So only lakshyartha of the words.
Okay.
So word satyam literally means truth, all right. But as we understand truth, all these words are used in our vocabulary, day-to-day language, and their words only connote some vyavaharic meaning. So, satyam means truth. But normally truth means that is opposed to untruth.
Correct. Okay.
Whereas truth is absolute truth, is unopposed to untruth. In the sense that both what we call truth and untruth have vyavaharik satta, is mithya, whereas truth in real sense is absolute or satyam. So, satyam is not opposed to mithya. It's meaning that vyavaharic truth is opposed to vyavaharic untruth. But absolute truth is not opposed to truth or false. Because the whole vyavahara is superimposed upon absolute truth or paramatma. So satyam, jnanam, anantam, each word we as we understand. We understand the context in which we are raised. And therefore every word is understood, not absolutely, but always in some context. Satyam also is understood generally in context of asatyam. Or, you know, jnanam also in reference to jnanam. Anantam with reference to, because in your mind, when you think of infinite, only with reference to finite, you think of infinite.
Right.
So infinite cannot really become objectified by the mind.
It's beyond comprehension.
But beyond comprehension means that it is a different infinite, different kind of infinite from the infinite that we understand in our vyavahara. Because When you think of infinite in your own mind, always think of it in reference to finite. When you say that there are no horns on a rabbit. In your mind you first visualize horns and rabbit together and say that there are no horns on the rabbit. So every word is able to convey its meaning only with reference to something else. Kashchid vastu.
You can ask that in that context, instead of those words, asti bhati prem would have been a better selection of words. Is it synonymous or it is
a... Yes, synonymous.
Synonymous, right?
Not better.
Okay, got it. Synonyms. But to him it might be that words, to me it might be the, but ultimately...
somebody may find these words more... perhaps conveying the meaning in a clearer way. Mm-hmm. That's a preference.
But lakshyar se macche banne.
Haan, na vachyar sar ko hai.
Okay, vachyar from sar ko hai. God. Okay, yeah.
But then is it that the Atma is characteristic less because it doesn't have...
Characteristic is not a very good word used there.
Okay.
Meaning they do not describe Atma. These words do not describe Atma.
Completely.
Yeah. Right. Atma cannot be the meaning of a word. No word, because Atma being limitless, and word can only convey something limited.
Right.
Because that's how we are accustomed to understand the words.
Right.
Everything in the universe is limited. And so words, as we understand, always mean something limited. So Atma cannot be the literal meaning of any word, even Atma.
Right.
How you know the word Atma? Because Atma means I. Hmm. Now I, as I understand, excludes you. You see, in my concept of I, you cannot be included.
Correct.
But we want an I that includes everything. So even the word I or Atma also cannot be the... Atma cannot be the meaning of these words. Therefore, we have to ultimately go beyond the word. Yato vacho nivartante, where these words also return. Meaning that in the knowledge of Atma, no word remains.
Thank you for initiating this discussion. So then sanction and insanction, tamane e word nu mane ajo clarity nathi samaj padti, even lakshya. What does, when you are saying, many times I have heard in many verses and many discussions, still I am not, what exactly in relationship to Atma, sanction and insanction.
Oh, sanction and insanction.
Yes.
Aha. Sentient is that which manifests life. Insentient which doesn't have life.
Le sajiv ne nirjiv. Sajiv ne Gujarati ma jo perspective ma.
Sajiv ne nirjiv.
But Atma is through
consciousness
both.
Consciousness is a principle which is different from just sajiv. It includes sajiv and nirjiv both.
ओके એટલે એ ક્લિયર એ મને ક્લિયર થતું મને બહુ વખત પછી હવે હું ક્લિયર થાય છે કે વેન સ્વામીજી સેઝ ધેટ ઇટ ઇન્ક્લુડ્સ બોથ સજીવ અને નિર્જીવ એ મને બહુ વાર લાગી છે
સો સજીવ નિર્જીવમાં ધેટ વિચ ઇઝ કોમન ટુ બોથ ઇઝ કોન્શિયસનેસ
એ બહુ વાર લાગી મને સમજતા બીંગ અ ફિઝિશિયન ધેટ વોઝ અ પ્રોબ્લેમ
બીકોઝ કોન્શિયસનેસ એન્ડ સેન્શન્સ આર ઇક્વેટેડ નોર્મલી
રાઇટ અને એ મિસકન્સેપ્શન મગજમાંથી જતા જતા બહુ વાર લાગી એટલે
In fact, that is what when science says that consciousness created in brain, it is only sentiency.
Right. And being that professional, that was a problem. That was a professional hazard. At a brain level.
A very important thing.
Yeah, very important.
No, yeah. Very few understand the difference between senses and consciousness. Everybody equates them.
Right.
So that there is consciousness there and not in that world.
Right.
Because we, consciousness is generally understood as a state of mind. So I am conscious of myself and other things. Whereas the wall is not, so that's how we distinguish. But that conscious of is nothing but conscious with my mind.
Right.
So one which has mind and which doesn't have mind. Subtle body and doesn't have subtle body.
Yeah.
But that because of which I am conscious. Is consciousness.
I'm physician of matter, I was to samajh bhi seen li, but at that level bahut jaruri thi. Ye vastu fayda karti thi, ye vastu gair fayda kare thi being a physician. Kya bahut mainne takleef pade. I mean, I'm talking of myself, but that's the problem. Physician.
So then the next verse, now it seems like I'm reaching to a point that I am going to use help. So this is...